What if we spent the summer by the sea? Just you and me, and wait, let me begin again. What if I spent the summer by the sea? My feet in the sand, head full of ocean spray and the sound of a siren. What if I lost everything again and had to pick up the pieces, reset myself, and realign with words and quiet and loneliness? Maybe there will be a cat named Trouble whose missing ear gives him a quizzical look as he waits for his special food from his special person. I am not that person. Trouble avoids me unless I'm outside in the sun. Then we bask together, and he comes in for an occasional head rub. I'm a bit like Trouble, happy in my quiet place, happy to have my head rubbed, happy to meander in the sunny afternoon until a nap overtakes my ambition. Maybe the warmth and salt will burnish away some of the loss that has attached like old barnacles to my legs and arms. Maybe inhaling the moist heat will warm my insides and ferret out the sadness, all of it, laid bare like a dry, gray piece of driftwood. I will admire my old sadness there, still and lifeless on the beach. I am giving her no more play. She served me deeply and released me back into the stream. This life passing by is caught and measured through words. As I attempt to illuminate my journey, not for others to follow, but for my own edification. If I don't learn and evolve, I will simply repeat the same mistakes, suffer the same fate, and write more broken love poems. I suppose that's not so bad here by the sea, alone. As the days blaze white hot outside my window, I cannot hear the ocean. I cannot hear her voice telling me I am loved, I am safe, I am making her life happier. I only hear the sound of my typing, the inner monologue of these characters becoming words, of possible futures, lamentable pasts, and, oh, this persistent present.